boys and girls. Welcome again to Poetry Just for You. Today we have very special guests visiting our studio. We have Joseph Lake, Erica Lake, and Robert Dixon. We also have another very special guest, Mrs. Marcia Early.
It's a pleasure to be here.
And she's brought her friend, Miss Melody.
Hello.
Miss Early is an opera singer, and she sings with the New York Opera Forum. And she's here today, and we will all join her and sing. As you know, a song is just a poem set to music. So sing with me. It can be done so easily. We'll sing and join our voices over hill and dale and forest, never minding wind or weather. We're together. Sing with me. It can be done so easily. It is the melody of our friendship. Today's story is about Susan and her visit to a reading lab. I'm sure many of you have a reading lab in your school. This reading lab is located in PS 75 in the Bronx. Our story begins on September 14, 1987 at 9:30 a.m. Susan is passing the reading lab, and she overhears a chorus of voices. She stops to listen. I love to go to school each and every day, 'cause I'm making lots of friends as I work and as I play. Hi, I'm Miss Alphabet. I'm sure you know me, but just in case you've forgotten my letters, please sing along with me.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Hello, I'm Mr. Vowel. The letters A, E, I, and U are called vowels. They are very important letters of the alphabet because each word and each syllable in the word must contain one or more vowels. But what is a syllable? Did I hear someone call my name? I'm Miss Syllable. You will recognize me if you see a group of letters said together which make a part of the word. Some words have one syllable, like cat. Others are made up of two or more syllables, like table and animal. Oh, I see. Well, I know a song that may help me remember vowel letters and syllables. I'll just sing Old MacDonald a different way.
Old MacDonald had a farm, A-E-I-O-U, and on his farm he had a cat. A-E-I-O-U, with a cat cat here and a cat cat there. Here a cat, there a cat, everywhere a cat cat. Old MacDonald had a farm. A-E-I-O-U.
Excuse me, everyone. I think you've left me out of your discussion. And I'm also very important. You see, all of the letters which are not vowels in the alphabet are consonants. And sometimes my letters can even sound like vowels. For example, the Y can sound like the long vowel letter E, as in baby. Oh, Mr. Consonant, we could never forget you. Why, we need you when we write and spell. And I must add that consonants make up all my blends, such as BL in blue, GR in green, SK in skate, SCH in school, THR in through. Oh, Mr. Blen, I've seen you many times. Sometimes I even blend the vowels as well, like O-I in noise, O-U in house. And don't forget that I need you too, Mr. Consonant. But who are you? You just said it. When you said who, W-H as in who is a digraph. I am just a cluster of two consonants which form a single speech sound in a word or in a syllable. So I'm C-H in church. I can be placed almost anywhere in the beginning, middle, or end of a word. Oh, I'm so pleased to have met all of you. And I hope to meet you again and again when I begin to read. Well, why not begin today? Will you read the story? I will certainly try, Mr. Paragraph. But first, would you please tell me a little about yourself? I'm Mr. Paragraph. I make up one complete thought or idea. Read my story and see if you can tell me what the story in the paragraph is all about. Read it silently at first, and then read it aloud or orally. Okay. Ready? Get set. Go. I visited the reading lab. I made many friends. I met Miss Alphabet, Mr. Vowel, Mr. Consonant, Mr. Blend, Mr. Digraph, and Mr. Paragraph. I had a good day. That was excellent oral reading. Now, Susan, can you tell us what the paragraph was all about? Can you tell us the main idea? Yes, the paragraph was about a visit to the reading lab. That's correct. Susan, let me introduce myself. I'm Mr. Detail. Can you find me in the paragraph, too? I can give you the important facts in a paragraph. Why, yes. But first, let me reread the paragraph to find the details. Oh, Mr. Detail, you represent the special people I meet. Miss Alphabet, Mr. Vowel, Mr. Consonant, Mr. Blend, Mr. Digraph, and Mr. Paragraph. Yes, you are correct. You must have been thinking while you were reading. Yes, I always read with a question in mind. That is how I can locate information. My teacher has taught us a poem about reading and thinking. The poem is entitled Silent Reading, and it says, with a question in mind, through the pages we zip, reading with our eyes and not with our lips. Let's all say that poem together, boys and girls. With a question in mind, with a question in mind, through the pages we zip, through the pages we zip, reading with our eyes and not with our lips. Good. Well, I really must return to my class. I only stopped for a little visit because everyone and everything looks so cheerful. Come and see us again very soon, Susan. I will, and you can be sure that I'll be looking for you as I read each and every day. Boys and girls, I hope you read each and every day. And like Susan, I hope you will stop in and visit your reading lab in your school.
New York State instituted the nation's first mandatory safety belt use law in 1985. During the 5 years since, 1,216 lives have been saved, 88,612 injuries prevented, and $544 million in medical expenses avoided. $1.5 billion in productivity has been restored to the state economy. $313 million in property damage has been averted, as well as $37 million in government costs that would otherwise have been paid for by our taxes. Another $180 million in insurance fees and $446 million in legal fees have remained in our own pockets. The probability of being injured or killed in an automobile accident during the course of a 75-year lifetime is 86%. Wearing your safety belt reduces that probability by half.
Boys and girls, welcome back to Poetry Just for You. In the story of Susan's visit to the reading lab, she overheard the children reciting a poem, A Message for My Teacher. This poem is dedicated to the boys and girls of PS 75 in the Bronx. I'd like for you to read it along with me. I will read it first, and then Miss Melody and myself will alternate as you read along with us. A message for my teacher. I love to go to school each and every day, 'cause I'm making lots of friends as I work and as I play. I'm trying very hard to do the best I can. This makes my parents proud. I'm a good citizen. Look for me each day. I'm the one with the bright smile. And I'll look for you too. Then we can chat a while. Miss Melody, boys and girls, are you ready? I didn't hear you. Are you ready?
Yes, we are.
I'd love to go to school.
I'd love to go to school.
Each and every day.
Each and every day.
'Cause I'm making lots of friends.
'Cause I'm making lots of friends.
As I work and as I play.
As I work and as I play.
I'm trying very hard.
I'm trying very hard.
To do the best I can.
To do the best I can.
This makes my parents proud.
This makes my parents proud.
I'm a good citizen.
I'm a good citizen.
Look for me each day.
Look for me each day.
I'm the one with the bright smile.
I'm the one with the bright smile.
And I'll look for you too.
And I'll look for you too.
Then we can chat a while.
Then we can chat a while.
That's very good. Boys and girls, you have excellent listening skills. And I'm sure you make your parents quite proud. When you're in school, in addition to learning all about the alphabets and finding the main idea of a paragraph, you also learn some safety rules. I have a poem today about safety rules. I hope you will say this poem along with me also. But it's my turn now, so listen carefully. Safety rules. I learned how to cross the street today. I'll tell you what to do. Wait for a green light, then look both ways, and walk across quickly, too. I learned how to cross the street today, and now I know what to do. Cross on the green, after looking both ways, now you know it, too. Are you ready, boys and girls?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. I learned how to cross the street today.
I learned how to cross the street today.
I'll tell you what to do.
I'll tell you what to do.
Wait for a green light.
Wait for a green light.
Then look both ways.
Then look both ways.
And walk across quickly, too.
Then walk across quickly, too.
I learned how to cross the street today.
I learned how to walk the street today.
And now I know what to do.
And now I know what to do.
Cross on the green.
Cross on the green.
After looking both ways.
After looking both ways.
Now you know it too.
Now you know it too.
Miss Melody, what light do we use when we're getting ready to cross the street?
Green.
Oh, excellent. And what way do we look before we cross the street?
We look both ways.
Oh, excellent. You are just wonderful.
Thank you.
One thing that I enjoy is a visit from a postman. And many of you receive mail also. You have to write to your relatives and your friends, and they will return with a letter to you. The postman. I waited for the postman. He always comes my way and brings letters from my friend who lives far, far away. I didn't see the postman. He must have hurried by. But he left this little postcard. It's the one that just says, hi. Miss Melody, where is that postcard?
It's right here.
Oh, I see. Let's see if we can say that poem together. The postman.
The postman.
I waited for the postman.
I waited for the postman.
He always comes my way.
He always comes my way.
And brings letters from my friend.
And brings letters from my friend.
Who lives far, far away.
Who lives far, far away.
I didn't see the postman.
I didn't see the postman.
He must have hurried by.
He must have hurried by.
But he left this little postcard.
But he left this little postcard.
It's the one that just says hi.
It's the one that just says hi.
Boys and girls, could you raise your hand if you've received mail recently? Wow. Then you must be great writers. That is simply fantastic. Miss Melody, what about you?
I got a letter yesterday, and here it is.
Oh, I see. I see. Very fine.
Do this, do that, go to school. Seems like somebody's always telling the kid what to do. Well, not this kid. I've had it with school. Nobody's telling me what to do anymore. They even wanted me to go to this place after school. What was it called? Oh, yeah, the Boys and Girls Club. Are they crazy? I got no use for drawing pretty pictures and playing games. Or whatever they do in there. That's not for me. That's not my style. Nah, I never went to that place. Hey, I'm getting out of here. I'm gonna get some cash in my pocket, start doing things my way. Listen, I'm going places.
Fact. This year's high school dropouts will cost America over $240 billion in lost earnings and tax revenues. Support the Boys and Girls Club, the club that beats the streets.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to Poetry Just for You. The next poem that I'll read is What is a Doll? A doll is someone you can hold very close and tell your secrets to. A doll is someone dear who can sit next to you just anywhere. A doll is simply your best friend, a friendship which will never end. A doll is company too. She'll help you play peekaboo. A doll will join you in a prayer as you ask God to bless those for whom you care. So may God bless you both each night and day, and those whom you love in every way. This morning, Miss Marcia Early will sing the evening prayer from Hansel and Gretel. Miss Early?
Now I lay me down to sleep, pray, dear Lord, my soul to keep. Watch above me, Lord, I pray, through the night till break of day. Angels here beside
And thank you so much, boys and girls, for visiting with us. Poetry Just for You is seen on Westchester Cable Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. We hope you will visit again with us. So may God bless you both each night and day, and those whom you love in every way. Goodbye for now, boys and girls.
Bye.
All right, no homework today. Let's do something fun.
Yeah, why don't
we? Hey, you looking for fun, huh? Wanna smoke some weed?
We better not.
Don't worry about those hooks.
We'll go somewhere that's really fun.
This is great!
Now you can have fun.
Discover the club that beats the street.
Your local Boys and Girls Club.
Grandpa, Grandpa, want to see what I made for you?
Sure I do.
Yeah, and I made it today. Do you think I'm a good teacher?
Of course.
What Grandpa sees is not due to aging eyesight. It's a condition called low vision.
Looks real, huh, Grandpa?
Well, it's beautiful. What do you call it?
Grandpa, that's you.
If you or someone you love has a vision problem, call the Westchester Lighthouse, 761-3221.
Now, Wiley, me, don't hold me. Pretty Lord, my soul to keep. Watch above me, Lord, I pray, through the night till break of day. Angels here beside me, ever near guide me. Bless, O Lord, all mothers.
Thank you so much, Miss Early.
Route 22.
Hey, what's that? Your sister's phone number or something?
Wise guy. Oh, no. It's information telephone. You call 741-2222 for weather, sports, lottery numbers, and movie listings over 110 screens.
Wow, that sounds great. Hey, kid, let me use the telephone, huh?
Sorry, Rocky. Like I said, you're a free man now. Go find your own quarter.
Oh.
Midwestern boy on his own. looked at him with those soft eyes so innocent and blue. He knew right then he was too far from home.